I'm excited to be here, Daniel. This news release that we put out that we're going to be talking about, it's something that is very positive, and let's get into it. So
for sure, just let everybody know, if you have not heard of Brazil Resources, you can look at them at Brazil Resources, and the shares are BRI on the TSX Venture and BRIZF. And we regularly cover this story, and we'll keep you updated. So make sure you're also subscribed to futuremoneytrends.com for updates on this specific company. Amir, you guys did have a news release yesterday. I think it's important. What can you share with us about this recent acquisition?
Well, when you think about the whole business model for Brazil Resources and what we've been doing for over 6 years now, when the company started, and for 6 years, we've been making acquisitions in Brazil, in the U.S., and really having this concept around buying projects that had been previously explored, drilled, having the potential to become large projects and be unique in that sense of size and scale. So you think about kind of the textbook play, the textbook sort of acquisition that would be the fit for BRI. The project that we're acquiring from Nova Copper, called Titiribi in Central Colombia, which was announced just yesterday, this really checks all the boxes there. And that's what is really exciting for us here. In fact, at this point, I would say really this could become, as we come up with more news on it, and there's still some developments here to come, but I think this could go down to this point as one of the most important acquisitions that BRI has made in its six-year history. I think the key to really emphasize here is twofold. Again, remember, and you would remember this, but for your new listeners, is that while BRI has really benefited and enjoyed a strong year on the back of, obviously, improvement in the gold price, we didn't start 6 months ago. We didn't start 12 months ago. We started 6 years ago with this company. And it's been 6 years of really making the investment and identifying the right acquisition opportunities and looking where other companies or other people are not looking. It's interesting with this one, Dan. There's an interesting story here. People are not going to be looking for gold in a copper company. Well, that's what we did. And we started looking at this project a long time ago, actually, almost a year ago when we first became aware of it. But there was a company called Sunward Resources. Sunward Resources, late last year, merged with Nova Copper. And Nova Copper, as a result, became the owner of this project that we acquired today called Titiribi. And Nova Copper's main focus is in Alaska. That's where they have a copper project that they're advancing. And they really wanted to see the Titiribi Gold Project come into the hands of a company that is well-established, well-followed, and is really able to advance as a go-to name, as a gold play. And the fact that they were willing, and we structured this deal as an all-stock deal, they're taking equity in our company, which is less than 5% dilution to our shareholders. So in that sense, it's good for us. It's good for them to take the equity in BRI and see the further upside we can realize as we advance the project and as we advance in this gold market. I think in a way it's a vote of confidence, but in a way it's a win-win deal, and it's a way of showing that, look, when you can go out there and pick up a project that has had over 140,000 meters of drilling, we're talking about 270 diamond drill holes, and has been subject to work done on the engineering side, environmental side, in addition to the extensive drilling. And it's in an area where we're seeing development stage projects for gold, mining for gold that has started. Some of the companies in this area, like B2 Gold or Continental Gold or Red Eagle. I mean, this Titiribi mining district is probably one of the more important and oldest kind of mining districts in Colombia. I just feel we check a lot of boxes with that. I think this, as we come out and have more news on this, I feel quite positive and excited about this, but I tell you, it's taken us 12 months to get just to this point to be able to deliver such a meaningful transaction.
Well, it's certainly very exciting. I mean, I've been with you guys and covering you guys since Cachoeira and Sal Horridge and Whistler. So to see and hear you say that this could most likely be the most significant acquisition going into this bull market. It's very exciting for everybody listening to this. We are talking to you in 2016. We have seen a great environment for gold stocks since late January. However, this week, actually, this second or third week of August, it is, it's actually been, somewhat of a correction for the gold shares, for the sector wide. The GDXJ, is down today. It was down yesterday. What are your thoughts on this? Is this just a normal correction that's, probably maybe even needed?
Not only does it need the normal progression of the market, not only is it healthy, not only does it actually provide for, investors to come back into their favorite holdings and be able to take some prices. I also think it's very much seasonal as well. I mean, look, we're at a time of the year where people are obviously taking vacations, they're out at the beach, and the volumes are obviously lower. And there's no doubt that we have the seasonality effect here as well with the month of August. But anytime you see Fed talk and have that put some pressure on the gold price, the pullbacks are bid and bought quite aggressively. Gold price is definitely holding in. We've got a very important 3 months to 6 months to 12 months coming up with the election cycles, U.S. election, European elections, and continued signs of concern in the global economy, and nothing has changed about the trillions of dollars of government debt that is now yielding negative interest rates. Nothing's changed about the fact that the Fed has left really with limited capability, and its balance sheet clearly does not look like it's got the capability or even further quantitative easing will have the efficacy that they hope it will have. Again, it continues to be an environment where we easily have 2 to 3 years of stronger gold market and precious metal prices ahead of us. It's hard to predict beyond that, but it's just very clear to us that at this point, and it's very clear to me, that we're in the very early stages of this incredible bull market for gold. And Dan, isn't it incredible for investors to see why historically, because I think we all forgot it. Remember, it was right before the beginning of this year, we were in a five-year bear market, which, by the way, again, in our mind, that's why it was the best time to buy assets during that downturn. But in that downturn, we all forgot, and I think investors almost forgot, why historically this sector is where fortunes are made. Historically, why investors gravitate towards the junior exploration mining sector, because when a commodity moves up 30% like gold has done, the response by equities and fund the equities, where they can go up 200 to 400%, is real, and it has happened. And, you know, in such a short time span. But it's an incredible reminder about the potential of this sector. We were obviously starting from a very low point because of the 5 years of beating that the whole sector had taken prior to the beginning of this year. But I still don't think the generalist investors are in. I still don't think that from a portfolio allocation point of view, you have the right allocation in this. So I'm very excited what could happen in the coming 6 to 12 months. And I think the pullback, broadly speaking, this month is very normal and very healthy and very needed.
Sure. Yeah. And, you know, when you talk about like the retail investors, you know, they talked about the Sprott conference being sold out. But still, I mean, there was only a few hundred people. It wasn't as if, you know, I remember going to shows with you in San Francisco, gosh, 3-4 years ago, there would be 300 booths and thousands of people there. Amir, you had mentioned that looking forward, the gold fundamentals look very good. So let's close this interview off with, for investors who are looking at Brazil Resources, what can they expect for, let's say, the next 6 months into a year? Obviously, you guys have way over-delivered when it comes to delivering value during the bear market. How is this transition going to affect your own business, and where does it take Brazil Resources over the next, let's say, 12 months?
I think it's very important to look at how, for a company like Brazil Resources, who has been focused on making acquisitions and then really deriving value from those acquisitions. It's important to see, for example, how last summer, when we acquired the Whistler project up in Alaska, and how at that point, that then allowed us then from there to have fairly meaningful news flow over the course of the next 6 to 9 months with three different 43-101 reports that were released, more information about the project that came out, and really set the stage for a good part and a meaningful part of the rally that we had in the early part of this year. When your focus is on making acquisitions as a company, and when you're out there not just trying to do small ones, but meaningful ones, when it's taken a year just to bring this acquisition into this point that it is now, the key is to remember that from this point on, I think we now have really the making for a project that we're going to be able to talk more about. So, for example, right now we've announced that we've acquired a project and entered into an agreement. On or about September 1st, we'll be announcing the closing. And from that point on, we'll be able to hire the necessary people, the independent engineers and geologists, to complete an updated 43-101. There's so much work that was done on this project, so much history, that we'll be able to really have a strong news flow cycle on the back of this project. And the same way that our last meaningful acquisition, Whistler, set this stage for a strong period of news and activity and demonstrating the value of that acquisition, this acquisition now, while it was announced during a very quiet time in the market, being in the middle of August, as we go into September, October, really gives us the next round of developments and updates and news flow for BRI. I'm excited about that. I think we'll be able to demonstrate, as more news comes out about this, people will look back at this interview and say, we understand why Amir, quote unquote, called this perhaps the most important acquisition that BRI has in fact made in its history to date. And really, when you think about what we've set up until now, we want to make accretive acquisitions, and we want to be able to deliver on that. This, I think, checks the box that shows, look, BRI is able to and has shown that it can continue to deliver on that. We've done it for 6 years, but we're going to continue to do that. And it would be probably important and also necessary at some point in the fourth quarter for us to consider some kind of maybe almost rebranding strategy. You know, now we're in three different jurisdictions. We're in the U.S., we're in Brazil, we're in Colombia. To some extent, perhaps the name that gave birth to this company, Brazil Resources, is no longer accurately reflecting this very extensive and diversified portfolio that we have. So it also will be exciting and I think probably important. We can derive more value from a rebranding and a communication strategy that really allows the market to fully appreciate all the intrinsic value that we've built in Brazil Resources.